30 years ago, China was still considered a developing country. Today, it is the world's second largest economy and a world power which no one can ignore. This journey from scarcity and poverty to prosperity and abundance is the fastest in the history of the world. But in the official history of China's unrivaled economic success, there is no mention of the events in the early summer of 1989. Events which indirectly hastened the economic development for which the world admires China today. When China's first communist leader, Chairman Mao Zedong, died in 1976, he was succeeded by fellow party member Deng Xiaoping. Under his leadership, China began to change the economic policies that had applied during the rule of Mao Zedong. The new policies, inspired by the economies of the Western world, led to steep increases in food prices, unemployment, inflation, and corruption. These changes caused great dissatisfaction and protests, and from the mid-1980s, demands for both economic and political change grew. In the spring and early summer of 1989, these protests culminated into what the rest of the world knows as the events of, or the massacre in, Tiananmen Square in Beijing on June 4th. This date and the events where at least 200 and perhaps as many as 1,000 people were killed is practically unknown in today's China. It is considered so taboo that it may not be mentioned in public.
So that was in the Tiananmen incident for me the most obvious and clear, even though it was my 前半辈子的那个生活里边最铭心刻骨的一件事情。Yu
Hua is one of China's great writers, with millions of books sold. In the West, he is best known for his book To Live, which was also made into a famous movie with the same title. In his new book, China in 10 Words, Yu Hua summarizes his view of China in 10 carefully chosen words. Chapter 1 in the book is entitled People, where Yu Hua for the first time writes about the atmosphere and the events in Tiananmen Square on the night leading to June the 4th.
当我从凌晨两三点钟从那个天安门广场那个时候骑车再回来的时候非常寒冷，而且路灯都没有。 因为当时那个街道比较狭窄，不像现在那么宽，可能已经没有这种感觉了。突然往前骑的时候，感觉到前面有一种热浪过来，有一阵热气一点一点的过来，10000多人在那唱那个国歌，哇，这个场面确实是非常的那个震撼。各位自由，各位自由，立即退化，立即退化。所以我后来就。 在文章里边写到的，就是我以前一直以为，就是人的光线应该是传得比人的声音远，声音应该比热量，因为热量应该传的是最近的，是吧？但是后来发现，当人民团结起来的时候，身上的热量传得比光和声音都要远。这是一个很奇妙的感受，以前从来没有过，以后也不会有了，我估计。
The student demonstrations had been going on since April and kept growing increasingly larger when China's leaders decided that the square should be evacuated on the night leading to June 4th.
在那个坦克上的那个军人给他们的命令是可以开枪，但是往下面打，也可以往天上打。那么当时有大量的那个死亡是因为有些子弹反弹的时候打在了胸膛上，动脉被打断了。 所以为什么我那个看到街道两边啊，上面高一点的地方都没有枪眼，沿着那个地起来那个地方全是枪眼。
The interview with Yu Hua is interrupted by security personnel when they hear Tiananmen Square mentioned and the film crew is asked to leave.
我跟张经理说好的，可以在这里拍采访。您关于什么题材的？
，他就是一个很普通的人，那什么，他就算他能够听到我们在谈论那个天安门事件的时候，他就会说，那个不要讨不要那个那个危害国家的话题是不能谈的，什么哦违反国家法律的话题是不能谈的，问他什么是国家法律，他也不懂，他又到不要伤不要危害社会，我问他社会是属于人民的还是属于官方的，他非常厉害的说这个不是你说了算的。 经历过两次那个巨大的游行，大概有100多万。当时我们那个报道说是有近200万，但也有可能有非常非常大规模的那个游行。大学生们要求民主自由，这个对很多当时中国的百姓来说是太遥远的事情。真正能够吸引全国的市民啊、民众加入进去，而不仅仅只是一个学生运动。
The death toll is still unknown. Maybe there were 200 dead, maybe 1,000. Many were imprisoned, and many others fled the country.
If 1989年的事件发生在今天的话，那肯定不可收拾。 因为那时候的社会矛盾并不突出，大家刚刚从那个文革中出来，经济一年比一年好，很多年过去，到了90年代以后，他们都认为那个还有部分人认为这个开枪可能是对的，否则他认为中国会乱，会怎么怎么就没有后来的那个经济的那个发展。
六四事件以后，我们的政治体制改革停止了，不再改了，绝对不动，因为当时一动认为这国家要出乱子，共产党可能要失去他的政权，所以他就政治体制改革，但经济体制改革是疯狂的，完全是像那个不是像欧洲的那个学美国，因为美国的资本主义是世界上最坏的那个资本主义。我希望它没有发生，因为这对任何人来说都是悲剧。
The silence settled over Tiananmen Square, as did the silence about Tiananmen Square, and yet another dramatic chapter in China's history was over.